There's a lot of entertainment news in the world right now because seemingly the movie and TV industry are back to it, and they're cranking out lots of projects that have come from all of these ideas that they've conjured up as they were all sitting at home during COVID. So what that means for us is a lot more things to watch, which is a good thing, but way more than I could ever talk about here on today's program. So I suggest you hop online, go to an entertainment website like ET, and check out all of the new trailers for the new TV shows and the new movies that are going to be available in the next year, year and a half. I did want to touch on one more, however, because I'm a sci-fi geek, and the Netflix series of Lost in Space is absolutely awesome. They just released a teaser trailer for the final season the other day.
This is Will Robinson of the 24th Colonist Group. If you're watching this recording, there's a chance things didn't work out the way I hoped they would. I thought I could save everybody. I'm doing this so you all can survive. Because you're my family. And I love you. I just hope it's enough. This is my final transmission.
Are you ready for the robot apocalypse? Well, we might be getting closer to it at least. A newly developed bipedal robot can seamlessly switch between walking and flying. And it's the combination of these two skills that really sets this futuristic machine apart. Introducing Leonardo, or Leo for short. The name is an acronym for Legs On Board Drone, which nicely but insufficiently described the robot. The Caltech engineers who built Leo didn't just slap a pair of robotic legs onto an aerial drone. They had to design the bot with both walking and flying in mind and develop specialized software to integrate its various components. Leo is still a prototype, a kind of proof of concept to see if a bipedal flying robot can actually perform tasks that would otherwise be difficult or possibly impossible for ground robots or aerial drones to accomplish on their own. In the future, a full-fledged version could be tasked with difficult or dangerous jobs such as inspecting and repairing damaged infrastructure, installing new equipment in hard-to-reach places, or attending to natural disasters or industrial accidents. Eventually, a Leo-like robot could even transport delicate equipment to the surface of a celestial body, such as, say, Mars or Saturn's moon Titan. More ominously, the agile bipedal flyer could be used in defense or warfare. Leo's sci-fi attributes are not an accident. In an email, the team said they were inspired by the fictional flying humanoid robot Astro Boy and the Iron Man-like jet suits built by Gravity Industries' Richard Browning. Ultimately, however, the purpose of the project was to study the intersection of walking and flying from a dynamics and control perspective, and to give unprecedented walking ability and to solve problems posed by hybrid locomotion. The Caltech team is also hoping to build adaptive landing gear for vertical takeoff and landing on difficult terrain. Myself, I'm pretty sure they pulled this design straight out of, I believe, RoboCop 2. I'm pretty sure that's what the evil robot looked like, if I'm not mistaken. I absolutely love how the worlds of automotive and technology have really, really combined in the last few years with the advent of electric vehicles, or at least the proliferation of them. New automotive startup brand Savic Motorcycles is set to become Australia's first high-performance and zero-emissions electric motorcycle manufacturer. This thing looks wicked. The Victorian-based brand, founded by ex-Ford Australia optimization engineer Dennis Savic, has announced it raised around $1.1 million worth of funding, which is going to greenlight the production process. More than half of the co-investment has come from the federal government's Advanced Manufacturing Growth Center, which is a taxpayer-funded acceleration and investment tank for Australian businesses. Savic Motorcycles claims it will introduce three versions of its C-Series electric motorcycles by late 2022, and the entry-level variant is expected to start at around $12,900. Called the Savic C-Series Omega, the cheapest motorcycle in the range is planned to feature a 25-kilowatt electric motor, with the brand claiming performance akin to a 300cc petrol-powered equivalent. Savic also mentioned that it will introduce a 40-kilowatt C-Series Delta and a 60-kilowatt C-Series Alpha model at the same time, with list prices expected to start in the $16,000 to $23,000 range, respectively. Again, I'm pretty sure this is Australian prices, so cut that by about a third for U.S. prices. The most powerful Savic C-Series Alpha motorcycle will feature a 16 kilowatt hour lithium ion battery. That's going to enable it to travel roughly 250 kilometers on a single charge, and will enable it to go from 0 to 100K in 3.5 seconds. Alongside numerous Australian businesses involved in the project, Savic's engineering team is expected to begin collaborating a unique anti-lock braking system with Bosch Australia. Dr. Jens Godeman, managing director for AMGC, said Savic motorcycles are paving the way for electric mobility in Australia by leveraging the best of breed designers, engineers, and manufacturing partners to deliver motorbikes of unmatched performance for local and global customers. Savic is proof that when you embrace the entire manufacturing process from design to research and development, all the way through to sales, there are exciting times ahead for Australian manufacturing. The Savic motorcycle range will launch towards the end of 2022, at least in Australia. Oh my goodness, if you're like me and you are a Stargate fan, you are going to want to listen up. Of course, Stargate started with the movie back in the day, then it became a wildly popular TV show with Stargate SG-1. That brought in Stargate Atlantis, and then another one, Stargate Universe, and then it all came crashing to a halt when MGM dang near went bankrupt. Or maybe they did, I can't quite remember. It was a very, very touchy time. That was in the late 2000s. There was a financial crunch all over the US, and apparently Stargate was one of the things that got axed in the schedule. And not just one of them, but all of them. It was very unfortunate, and I've been very sad about it for many, many years. Hopefully, with the recent purchase of MGM, things can get back on track. However, there is some news, some new project that is happening. It's not exactly what you're looking for, but it might be something to tide us over until official projects get released. Stargate AI is what I'm talking about. It's coming up November 6th, and you can reserve your place to check out the premiere live stream. You want to know what it is? I thought you might. Amanda Tapping, Jewel State, Michael Shanks, and David Hewlett, as far as we know, are all returning for a table read. Okay, it's not a new episode or a movie or anything, but they're all going to sit down together and read a brand new script led by creator Brad Wright, and the script is going to be written by cutting-edge artificial intelligence from Google AI. It's an incredible little project. The question is, can artificial intelligence write a Stargate script? Under the supervision of Stargate visionary Brad Wright, Google AI is going to give it a shot. If you become a member, you can join the live stream video premiere of the performance on November 6th at 2 p.m. Pacific time. However, spaces are limited, so you do need to sign up right away. If you miss it, I'm imagining they're going to let us watch it in video form later on. You may still have to subscribe to The Companion, but they have many, many podcasts and other interesting reads that might make their very low subscription rate something that will be easy to stomach. Just a note, they have not talked to me at all. They are not telling me to promote them. I just think it looks like an awesome website and a great little project, and think everybody should know about it if you are a Stargate fan, because I really think for an annual membership, $3.50 a month is not a big deal. If you just want to go for a month membership, it's $6.99, and you have a month to check out the entire site, all of their podcasts from past Stargate people and many other people across the entertainment industry as well. And then buckle in for what I hope is going to be a super funny, super exciting table read from Amanda Tapping, Jewel State, Michael Shanks, and David Hewlett. And, of course, Google AI. Once again, it's coming up November 6th. Reserve your ticket right now at thecompanion.app.